Hello, Kim Bach at KB Saxophone Service. So, I'm showing you how we are packing the saxophone, and after we packed it securely inside the saxophone case, next step is to pack the case with the saxophone securely inside the shipping box. The box that we are using is 39 inches by 16 by 12. It needs to be fairly large like that, so there's enough room for the bubble wrap around the case. You have to expect they will throw this case around. You should pack it so that you imagine they will be throwing it right into the wall, dump it on the ground from 5 foot and so on. So it has to be packed very securely. That's why we use an extra large box for it. You cannot get away with just using like a tiny box that just fits right around the saxophone case itself. There's a very high risk of the horn getting damaged then. So that's why we use a large box. So lots of large bubble wrap. And this is how we do it. First a little bit in the bottom. And then we have a couple of pieces that are folded up like this that we put at the ends, at each end. There's another one folded up twice. Three times at the end. Now the next thing is I'm going to use the big roll to roll around the saxophone case. So take this out of the way. Just placing it right in the middle of the bubble wrap. And then we, on a case like this, we get around four layers of bubble wrap, four or five layers at least. And just keep it nice and tight. I think that's three layers now. Four layers. Let's get one more. Yeah, and then I'm gonna just tear off the excess and tape this one down. Like that. All right. Next, I think I'm going to add one more layer in the bottom there. We have a couple of layers pushing in. And then we get the case right in the middle. So here we have the two parts we added in the ends here. They're going to take up wherever the bubble wrap is not wrapping the case here. So that's why we have those in before we put the case in. So that's important. You have those in first and then the case goes right down there. There we go. Now the rest of the space around I want to fill up so it's totally tight so it cannot shift around at all. And again, I just use a lot of the large bubble wrap for that. This case has been used a few times, shipping forth and back, so it has a little more flex in it. But that's okay. It's still usable. Make sure to get it nice amount of bubble wrap at the ends, at both ends of it, obviously, so that, you know, when they slam it in this way, you know, there's lots of protection.
start covering up the top of the case in both ends, trying to get it flush with the top of the roller bubble wrap here. And one thing you also want to do is you take a sheet like that and you roll it up and you add it on top here. If not, because of the way it's rolled, there's going to be a space right here.
Now I need to get some more bubble wrap. Just a minute. Alright, I got some more bubble wrap. So now I'm getting towards the end of the packaging. I want to make sure that it is very level, the bubble wrap everywhere. You don't want any parts of it where suddenly there's no bubble wrap or where there's way too much, because it's going to make it really hard to close the case. And yeah. So you just do it by feel. You just sort of pushing it in a little. Feel if there are any parts that's missing. I think I need a little more right there. And you try closing it. See how it feels. It's looking good. Make a little much right here. Pretty good. And then all I want to do now is tape it up really securely and